a really good preparation for next Friday, the Cascadia Leadership Center at the Humboldt Area Foundation asked me to finish up their 10-day leadership training to talk about community planning. And one of the things that they asked me was why I do the work I do, and one of their other questions is what got me started. So this is helping me think through what I have to do next week. And wellness is a theme and a topic that more and more over the past few years has gotten a lot of attention because no one agency, no one community can really address and tackle the issues of wellness by themselves. So for me, wellness is an array of topics. This handbook, we have a handbook for you that addresses an approach, community storytelling as an approach of improving wellness in your community. And I thought I'd start with a story about how I got into this work. Mm-hmm. And when I was a young man, I was fortunate enough to go to the Middle East as part of a college program. And it's one thing to be a Native American in the United States. It's another to be a Native American in another part of the world. And the professor who led our trip wanted us to see all perspectives in the Middle East. And we lived with Jewish host families, and we lived with Palestinian Arabs. And I got to see from that experience that many of the same things treasured and supported and honored by one group was exactly the same with the other group. But their divisions happen, and it's sometimes hard to get past those divisions. But one night, for the first time in 35 years, it had snowed in Jerusalem. And we were staying at a Palestinian-owned hotel in the West Bank. And early in the morning, we heard the rumble of tanks, and it shook our hotel. And my roommates and I, we ran to the hotel window, and we looked out on the cobblestone streets near the old city of Jerusalem. And we of course thought that we were going to war. The war had happened in the middle of the night while we were asleep. And turns out that Israel and Jerusalem aren't very well equipped for snow. So they don't have any snow plows. So to clear the busy city streets, they were using tanks. And tanks to not clear the road, snow, but crush it. And as soon as I could, I dressed and ran outside. And because I was in the Arab side of town, I fell in with a group of young men running around enjoying the snow. And as young men do, you start to make snowballs and throw them at one another. And then they went from snowballs to rocks, and the Jewish people were throwing rocks at us, and they were throwing rocks at me because they thought I was an Arab because I was running with the Arabs. And then as that part of the snow melted and I moved to a different part of Jerusalem, I fell in with a group of Jewish kids, young men, and the same thing happened, is that in a different part of town, the Arabs started to throw rocks at me, thinking I was a Jew, Jewish. And I really learned a lot that day, that you could be hated equally by different groups of people without knowing who you were. And spending that time in the Middle East to think about the differences in religion, competition for water and resources, it was really something that I came away with thinking that I not only wanted to help Indian people and Native Americans in the region that I wanted to live and work in and raise my kids in, but you can't really get something just by yourself. You can't really get something for your people without dealing with the realities faced by other people. You have to deal with them as well. So I'm guessing this is the group. So I need you guys to move a little closer, because this is now our community. I need you guys to move a little closer if you would. Thank you so much. And Connie, if you could, Connie and Joyce, if you could pass out that agenda. And I thank you so much. And I think for our communities, it's, and I wouldn't say this to a non-Native audience, even though I work with a lot of different groups of people. I'm not as comfortable in talking about tradition and culture and religion with other groups. But this idea of a community wellness plan and having your idea, and you're trying to move it forward into a community, whatever that might be, whatever aspect of wellness that's important to you. Wellness begins with us as individuals. It is a spiritual journey. And the more that we can think spiritually, act spiritually for ourselves, to get ourselves spiritually stronger, the less defensive we're going to be when naturally people don't necessarily always agree with our ideas right out of the gate. Even if it seems like a good idea initially, there's always going to be resistance to change, and it's natural. And as I've gotten older and just a little bit wiser, I've realized that not everyone thinks and acts like me. Laura Lee was saying in her panel presentation this morning that we all have strengths. We also all have weaknesses, and we have to figure those out. That's part of our individual spiritual journey. What am I good at? What am I not so good at? That's attempting to be honest with myself. But I've also come to appreciate that if any of you have ever played cards with, you know, the kids at ceremony and dance, they in the down times, we let them play cards. And I watched those kids, and I would never get involved in some of their card games. They're fast, and they're fast thinkers, and they know the process, they know the practice, they're good at it. And as you begin to weave yourself and your ideas into a larger community, it takes the ability to know what you're good at and build bridges and connections with people who are better than you in certain ways of thinking and doing and acting. But that's also, that gets back to the spiritual journey, that you have to be strong enough to accept that. There's two things that I've used a lot in my work I want to talk about before we get to the story-making tool. The first is that with each project and with each group I work with, I, for myself, accept all of the responsibility and accountability, and I strive to not receive any of the credit. And that is part of being spiritually strong as well, because you want to do the work, and it's natural for us as human beings to get credit and to be acknowledged for good work. But in dealing with communities, I found We get a lot more done if I and other people that are key to it aren't taking credit for it. And I wanted to say this in front of a larger group, and I forgot, but that's exactly what I see that NCIDC has done in organizing this this wellness summit, that the board of directors really wanted to see this happen, and the staff at NCIDC has really made it happen for the first time. It's hard for any organization to do something large for the first time, and I not only want to acknowledge that, but NCIDC for any tribe, excuse me, or any group, they're available to follow up on this morning's session and on this process in the future. If someone had a big idea that they wanted to see happen in their community, NCIDC would be available. Connie and Joyce.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
It's hot up here, I tell you.
So
awesome.
If you could just record some of their responses. If you could imagine that some of us live in multiple communities, smaller to larger. But imagine the community that you want to improve, please give Connie and Joyce some words that would define your improved, healthier community. What would the word be? Words, more than one, but words be that would help you to envision and imagine your community in a better, healthier
community
way.
Involvement?
Community involvement.
I was going to say awareness.
Yes, aware
of issues.
You know, cooperations.
Cooperation.
Support.
Support.
Crossroads, intersections with different agencies joining together to help.
Crossroads and intersections with agency involvement. Or, I'm sorry, did you have one? Okay. That table, a word.
Compassion.
Integration. Of
people returning back to
people returning home. Native Americans or anybody?
Anybody.
And I guess I go back to my story of snow in Jerusalem. I began to appreciate that it's any of us need, you know, access to our religion, health, shelter, warmth. Ma'am?
Respect.
You got another one, Darrell?